There's an old-fashioned Minnesota fruit fight going on in federal court right now.
Current law states that Minnesota wineries must use a majority of Minnesota grapes in their wines, but two local wineries are suing the state, saying they want the pick of the crop from somewhere else. Chris Rapsky has the story.
The Bailey family's been popping homemade bottles of wine for 44 years.
It was my father's dream to plant a vineyard here and make wine, and I'm continuing that.
Second-generation owner and winemaker Nan Bailey takes pride harvesting in the world's toughest grape-growing climate. But she feels Minnesota's laws have corked her business potential.
Because there's a restriction on my license that mandates that I grow 51% of my wines from Minnesota-grown grapes. There's only a handful of grapes that can grow in Minnesota.
Hello, good morning, and welcome.
So Tuesday, Bailey from Hastings and the owner of the Next Chapter Winery in New Prague filed a federal lawsuit against the Minnesota Department of Public Safety. In it, they argue Minnesota law violates their constitutional right to interstate commerce.
Are you trying to make Minnesota wines un-Minnesotan?
When a brewery brings in hops and grains from Washington State to make their beer, are they less a Minnesota brewery? We're equally as proud of our Minnesota breweries. They don't grow their hops and grains. I'm a Minnesota winery. I do grow grapes, and I make my best wines from some of the grapes that I grow. But it's not enough. I can't make enough wine from my grapes here.
DPS, the department that enforces liquor laws, the department getting sued here, said it wouldn't discuss the specifics on open litigation. But the president of the Minnesota Grape Growers Association says the law is in place for a reason.
I'm not in favor of it. I just don't think it's going to benefit the 600-member organization, and there's roughly and probably a lot more people than that that are growing Minnesota grapes and hoping to find a market for it and to kind of keep the industry growing.
So now it's up to a judge. Keep the grapes local or let the industry breathe.
So if Bailey wanted right now, she could actually grab 99% Napa grapes and 1% Minnesota and make wine. But under the law, she'd have to get a manufacturer's license, and she couldn't sell it direct to the people.
Okay.
She'd have to go through the three-tier system, which is like wholesaler, distributor, liquor store. Take a little off, take a little off, take a little off. So it's possible, but you can't be this farm direct winery and sell like that. So the law is there.
Is that for a safety reason?
What's that? What part?
That whole distribution reason. I don't quite get
that. Oh, I don't know about distribution. I don't know how that works. There's a lot of laws.
If I'm an indie brewing, I can make beer, and then I sell it to you in a growler, or I sell it.
Right. That's a whole other story about liquor laws that's been deep, and that's a whole new one. But it's interesting. You know, do you protect the grape growers, or do you not?
It is interesting. Well, I guess we'll find out what the judge decides, right?
Drink up.
All right.